will do. How about that file? What's in it that these guys want so bad?
You know, it's on something called the Devil's Breath. Fisk was hired to build a secret research lab for it. I'm not clear what Devil's Breath is, but it seemed to scare Fisk. He compares it to Pandora's box.
Not much shakes Fisk. We need to... Taking guys. Whoa, what is up with that glowing stuff on your hand? Are you guys ghosts? Never fought a ghost before. I mean, I've fought specters, but, you know, technically, specters aren't ghosts. All ghosts are specters, but not all.
Shitting me.
Not cool with the hostage taking guys. Whoa, what is up with that glowy stuff on your hands? Are you guys a ghost? Never fought a ghost before. Cardio? Check. Huh. Looks antique. I think I know someone who could help track down where this came from. A job for later.
just talked to Craig. You are not the reporter he was sending. You don't even work for Heritage Arts.
Never said I did. Hi, Mary Jane Watson, Daily Bugle.
You will not write a word of what you saw.
For the record, what do you know about the file those masked men stole?
I don't.
What about the long history of stolen goods Fisk has lied at this auction house?
Your editor will be hearing from our attorney.
Mix. Did the last 6 months never happen?
Hell yeah, the hurricane's still going on. It's a tropical storm, 70 mile per hour Florence, hitting North and South Carolina. 880,000 without power right now. North Carolina, South Carolina.
Best density.
So, how's the grind with the Bugle?
Well, yeah, well,
September 14th, 2018.
So it looks like I'll be meeting with the legal team. Again.
As soon as he reads the article you're gonna write, guaranteed promotion.
So, you've been with me, guys. What's your take?
Just another night in the city. What's your take?
I feel like there's a bigger story there. Let's not make this all about business. How's it going with you? Did you get that promotion?
No, but we're on the cusp of something really big.
You know, Oscar would hire you in a heartbeat, right? One phone call to hear.
Sure, but Dr. Octavius is working. Millions of right where I should be.
Oh, sounds like it's more important than your other job. I've never heard you talk like that before.
I can change in 6 months.
Why did you ask me, Harry?
Oh, just dinner between friends.
Friends? Is that what we are?
Maybe we could be. You know, if that's what you wanted.
There's a lot of baggage here.
Sure, but is that so bad? I mean, baggage can carry good things too, like good money and keys, raspberry lip balm.
Do you remember why we broke up?
This is a trick question, isn't it?
Saved by the siren.
Talk to you later.
Seeing you two together again. You always were my favorites.
By bedtime. Just had dinner with my ex after saving her from masked criminals. And now I'm gonna go beat up a maniac who uses shockwaves to rob people. What a perfectly normal life you have, Peter Parker.
I just want to make sure you haven't left any equipment you built for your friend around the lab. It's no bother to me, but if the grant committee stops by again...
Don't worry, Doc. I make a point not to leave anything there. But I know my friend appreciates you looking out for him. There's a lot of people who don't like him very much.
That buffoon Jameson and his audience of sheep, please. The people who do great things in this world are those who don't let bullies like him stand in their way. People like us.
You said a mouthful, Doc. Take care. Coverage. I should look for more towers to activate. I beat this wrestler right after getting my powers. I've never had that much money before in my life. Or since, come to think of it. Guys aren't trading baseball cards.
It's a spider!
Aw, you guys are like little kingpins in training. So cute! Never take a day off. This tower. I If I was them, I might start thinking about a new name. The holdup guys are phoning it in lately. Appreciate the heads up. This piece of the Shocker's original uniform showed me how to protect myself from his blasts. Of course, they always upgrade, don't they?
Thank you. right now. We'll send you the safety t-shirt. You can wear it to show your support for the children of safety.
Safety gives you all the hope back. They gave me my daughter back.
Safety won't stop until no child dies from cancer.
Area, roughly 2.6 million people. In terms of power outages, well, when you hear the numbers, it's around 800,000 or so, and those numbers are just going to keep on going. So this is a problem that we're going to be dealing with for quite a while. In fact, through the weekend, into early next week, it may be last a lot longer than that when you have a reoccurring problem with the wind and the rain moving out, but then the problem of trying to restore services to so many people that need it, that's going to be another huge issue. It's an issue that a great deal of America is concerned with. And with that concern, you know what? We've got a full team here at the Weather Channel that's going to keep you up to speed, including your friend in line, Dr. Rick Knapp. Dr. Knapp, you know, it really is a thing that when we see these systems come on shore, we can't forget about the problems that they come with it as it surges further inland.
Yeah, it's just beginning in the Charlotte area, and even points, you know, within west of there will eventually get it. And once it starts, it's going to last a long time because of the very slow motion and the extraordinarily large size of this tropical storm. And there are so many flash flood warnings currently in effect over central and eastern North Carolina, starting into South Carolina. And you can imagine that once the center gets further inland, these bands will continue on the coast. So that's why this is going to be a long-lasting inland and coastal event. Most widespread power outages are closer to the coast, but they're likely far, far inland, all the way to the Appalachians. Asheville, for example, could experience power outages. And the flash flooding tomorrow night into Sunday, will start to extend farther and farther inland. We've got the flash flood emergencies in this area. Imagine some of that will start to take shape farther inland, and then look at what we're expecting for Sunday. Very likely some damaging, maybe even deadly flash floods if people aren't careful and stay off the road in places like Charlotte, North Carolina. So this is why you can't assume that just because you don't live near the coast that this isn't going to be a very destructive, dangerous system. Myrtle Beach, your rain did not increase, so your storm surge is here for a high time.
That matter, like Adobe Athletes. Improved stretch and heels for those that recover first with flex built in. No matter how much walking, sitting, dancing, or jumping through those ordinary requires, you're going to look and feel amazing. Guaranteed. Here.
Delicious, but it's worth 10 layers of crunchy pizza. today across the community. The Waffle House, I'm sure you saw Jim Cantore up there, they're without power. They're using gas to cook what they can. First responders and other people who may be looking for a hot meal right now and don't have the ability to make it for themselves. The threats are not over, even though now it's collapsing a bit. You know, earlier, even this evening, just within the last hour, we've seen some really strong gusts. And we still will be watching for gusty winds as we go through the overnight when we get some of those heavier bands moving. But the rain, it's not going to let up as we go overnight. And it's not going to let up tomorrow. We'll continue as we go through the weekend. We'll be measuring rainfall in feet here in Wilmington by the time we're done with slow-moving Florence. That will be the biggest danger or perhaps the deadliest threat from this. And it's not just for parts of eastern North and South Carolina, like areas in Wilmington, but also areas well inland, communities that could get swamped by some of these tropical downpours. So unfortunately, we know that there are problems yet to come. Here in Wilmington, it's not just the freshwater, the rainfall flooding we're concerned about, or that we've seen, but we've already seen that push of water from the Cape Fear River here. It reached its highest level on record. National Weather Service Wilmington confirmed that earlier. And we see it moving over the boardwalk here and right along the river, a riverwalk, a popular place for people to walk their kids, take the dogs, and that will swamped with water. We think that will be an issue moving into tomorrow because that persistent southerly southeasterly flow is not ending anytime soon because Florence just won't budge.
And let's face it, it's moving at 3 miles per hour. That is a leisurely walk speed. So you could walk along with this hurricane at that same pace, right? That is just unbelievable. What was Hurricane Florence, now Tropical Storm Florence, but don't put your guard down. The impacts continue. Look at this. Morehead City. My goodness, 23.04 inches of rain. That is not the current stat. That was just the most recent one that we have. So it's likely a higher number than that, which is very close to already breaking that record for the wettest tropical system coming through North Carolina. We still have a tornado threat through the rest of this evening. Tornado watch continues in eastern North Carolina until 11. We will likely need a new one after that because these afterbands will continue to have that spin. In fact, it's not just today. It's not just tonight. Tomorrow, we will continue to have the threat of severe weather, including tornadoes, eastern North Carolina into eastern South Carolina. So yes, people then places that haven't gotten into that tornado threat yet may very well do so as we continue on. We're watching this big spin, right? The center of our circulation is just barely onshore right here, barely crawling, but all of this is just an onshore onslaught. So we still have the impact here with regards to surge. All of these green kind of pickled colors, those are flash flood warnings. A couple of those are flash flood emergencies. Wind speeds increasing around Columbia, close to 45 mile per hour gusts. Around Charleston, 30 to 35 mile per hour gusts. Water issues, flash flooding outside of Wake Forest on US 1A, trees down because of big winds west of Raleigh, and even water rescues that were needed in the Goldsboro area. Power issues continue to become just staggering in their magnitude. The numbers of outages continue to increase. There are now at least 5 different counties of North Carolina, all with more than 50,000 customers each without power. The worst of it is in New Hanover, where 113,000 customers are without power. So the state number is at 732. The South Carolina outages are on the increase. Horry County has been red for a while, 72,000, but Florence and Marion are now both above 10,000 customers each with regards to out. Reynolds, that story is going to continue as we go into Reynolds. Well, and in your area, in Charlotte, Reynolds, the rain is really just starting to move in. The wind is just starting to move in. The power outages will begin and increase there as well.
Absolutely, you know, they do welcome things and everything, and there is some welcome things. There's also, again, that's part of the new population, so to speak. The temporary population is now moving in parts of Charlotte, and now the power line workers. We've met gentlemen that have been from Mississippi, from Michigan, folks that have been from really all quarters of America, including Texas. They're here, and they're on standby, waiting for the wind and the rain to die down. As soon as that happens, they do quite a bit of work, let's be honest. they do is super important. They clear out the roadways, they put the lines back up, they restore power. They're are subjective. That's what we have to ask. Say for your hospital, the electricity, that you have them. It's truly important. And the thing that's going to cause all of it is obviously the wind, but also the rain. Take a look at the rain story that we have for you to give you what we can anticipate in Charlotte. The Queen City, we can deal with anywhere from, say, 6 to 8 inches of rainfall, maybe as much as 10. And the key thing to remember, those may be a little bit on the light side. If this thing slows down, we may have areas that can pop up in excess of a foot. In Charlotte, if you have 3 inches of rainfall that falls in quick duration, you could have some problems. But this is going to be something we can be seeing, that high amount of rainfall that could extend all the way to Monday, perhaps even Tuesday. So you just use the heaviest rainfall, obviously, out along the coast, but when you go farther into the west half, the same kind of
attention, all units, there's a vehicle pursuit in progress.
Yeah, as I said,
please converge on
Tenderloin,
over.
We've got a whole team assembled to give you and your friends and your family the information that's so crucial, so critical to stay safe. So you're going to want to keep it here through the weekend on the Weather Channel. Someone you've seen quite a bit. And here's his wisdom. That is Dr. Rick Nabb. Dr. Nabb, you've been telling us for days and days what we can expect along the coast. Unfortunately, tragically, that has become a reality. And still it's unfolding. It will continue to unfold for days to come.
Yeah, and flash flooding continues to go up the scale in terms of the danger and the urgency and life-threatening situations unfolding in many parts of North Carolina. This is headed to South Carolina. Look at all of the flash flood warnings. Some of these are emergencies. I want to highlight some of the most recently issued ones. This is a new extended flash flood warning in the Myrtle Beach, North Myrtle Beach area, Horry County, surrounding areas till 2:30 a.m. And as it gets dark, it's going to get harder and harder to see how much water is on the roadways. Water could be rising, and it's at some point overnight, you're going to get onshore flow to back up any drainage the rivers are trying to do out to the ocean. Wilmington, flash flood warning until 2:15 a.m., and you will continue to get onshore flow. And we're approaching the midnight high tide cycle, so that's going to make this combined saltwater, freshwater problem even worse. Now, in the Jacksonville, North Carolina area, there's a flash flood warning, but that nasty band that has been going through Morehead City up into the central part of the state, that's over you. That situation could become even more dire. We saw the flash flood emergency there in Morehead City and Newburn, another area where we could have some storm surge flooding, and we saw this flash flood emergency up in the Goldsboro area. If you've heard that you need to get out from flash flooding and you can't, call 911 from the highest part of your structure. We're here to keep you safe. Stay with us.
What you probably would do, but my sources confirm, is that the perpetrators were wearing masks. Horrible, demonic faces. Yet another example of the explosion in mass criminals since Spider-Man came off the scene. Let's hear your thoughts. You're on, J. Jonah Jameson.
I see your point, but Spider-Man does look good. Hey, he's like that because he wears the mask. It's like prejudice.
Wrong. Here's a little lesson in the English language, my friend. Prejudice means to prejudge someone. Before you know anything about it, I know all I need to about Spider-Man. He runs around causing chaos, wearing a mask so he doesn't have to answer for his shenanigans, and a flashy costume so he gets attention to feed his judgment. Insatiable ego. Now, if I'm a mentally unstable person and I see getting all this coverage, what am I going to do? It's called copycat behavior, people, and it's ruining New York.
Call 844-300-3136 and start saving. Yeah, no interest and no payments for 12 months. Renewal by Anderson. A better way to a better window. Call 1-800-352-3613 now.
Houston. A break-in was just reported. Incident is ongoing near Union Square. Please copy.
Wild guess. Those guys breaking in don't live there.
What the hell?
Those guys don't look like locksmiths.
Do it!
Now, I'll turn this on. Yeah, I see y'all got it. Y'all ain't got much. Really much or nothing there, you see.
The combined fresh and salt water flooding, and we can't assume
arrangements because the center is constantly and they're not going to continue to have storm surge, especially high tide tonight that's going to occur. So in the coastal areas, this is even worse because of the onshore push. Because whatever falls into the rivers can't exit out into the ocean and will be covered in by the onshore flow. Very likely to lightning flash flooding in much of North and South Carolina tomorrow into Sunday, and it goes farther inland, including the Charlotte area, into the Appalachians as we go to the end of the weekend. So I want to tell everybody what to do about this. Main thing is to stay off the road. Don't drive under any water covered road or any closed road. Don't go into the water at all. You don't know what's in there. And evacuate if officials are telling you to do so. But if you're trapped in your home and you don't think you can safely evacuate and the water is rising, go to the highest level of your home and call 911. Because it might be just as dangerous, if not more dangerous, to try to walk or drive out of that area. And don't touch any electrical equipment that is wet. Speaking of electricity, a lot of it's going to be going out. Not just in these areas closer to the coast where the storm is now, but it's likely that townhouses will extend farther inland and even into the Appalachians and the Asheville area. Raleigh is another one of those locations. So here's another list of things to do to stay safe. Power outages can be surprisingly dangerous and deadly. Operate those generators outdoors, not in the garage, away from the buildings. Don't use candles or other lighting flames to let them fire drill. Stay away from those down power lines. You can see videos of the live lines. Don't touch them or anything they're touching, including water. And if you are needing to go somewhere else to take shelter and you have life-sustaining medical equipment, go someplace where that's not going to
T-shirt you can wear to show your support for the children of St. Jude.
Turn back over.
St. Jude won't stop until no child dies from cancer.
St. Jude has given us hope for the future.
Go online or call with your $19 monthly gift. Let's end childhood cancer together.
Category 1.
why that may not matter at all in some cases. This is really one of those cases where you've got such a slow-moving system, such a large system, and you're getting so much rain over the same areas that the impact is going to be devastating. It is already in many spots, and we've got a long way to go before this is all said and done. So that center of circulation very close to Myrtle Beach right now, moving extremely slowly to the west of 3 miles per hour. And look at this band that is now driving into areas near Moorhead City. This is a 3-hour radar that has barely moved in that time, and the result has been an incredible amount of rain. That's the 24-hour rainfall, a very large area of greater than 5 inches of rain. But then within that, this is a pocket of 12 to 18 inches of rain that has come in with the system, and we've got reports that are on the order of 14 inches in some areas here. So there is an ongoing flash flood emergency in effect for Carteret, Craven, and Pamlico counties. We are hearing about widespread flooding of homes, businesses, and roads in this area. And we actually heard from the National Weather Service. They are saying that this is a terribly dangerous situation. Most roads are impassable, and citizens are losing time to evacuate. This has gotten very, very bad indeed. And now, in the county to the west, there's not now a flash flood emergency, but there are persistent rainfall rates of 2 to 3 inches per hour. Jones and Onslow County, that's going to be another area of concern. Also, flash flood emergency in Johnston and Wayne counties. That is going until 10 p.m. And we've got a flash flood warning in effect in Raleigh, North Carolina. That's going until 12:45 in the morning. About 3 inches of rain has fallen there. So widespread flash flood warnings across the central and eastern part of the state there. And so we just want to reiterate, do not drive into water at any time. Do not go around barricades. And if you're in trouble, go to the highest level, and you need to call 911. And let's go back out to Alex Wilson now, reporting from Wilmington. And Alex, it is just unbelievable how long of a duration we're looking at here. We're going to be in this tomorrow, all day tomorrow, and then even into Sunday as well. It's only going to be lifting up into the western part of the state.
Columbia could all have serious or XPD for the next 24 hours. Here's how warm it has. The problem is, Florida's moving so slowly, taking a good old time getting out of here, that we're going to have prolonged issues. So the question is, think about this, is this, as Florida moves away, we'll get the back side of Florida. Okay, that means the winds come down gradually to the rain chamber. However, we'll then get an onshore flow, whereas all day long today, and through the night, we'll have an offshore flow. Storm surge has been no issue whatsoever. Tomorrow is winter. With an onshore flow, it means the Atlantic Ocean comes up. Remember, we drain the water out of our river basins and our storm drains out to the Atlantic. If the water's higher in the Atlantic, we can't effectively drain the rainwater and the floodwater away, which means the floodwater should stay up in neighborhoods longer than you may normally expect, and then they rise, or you would normally expect, especially when ongoing rain.
Search for the back
at 7-7, and keep this in mind, tempo. Search services may not respond to your 911 calls because the weather is taking a short work. Fire. And police respond to any natural calls. So you're up or down tonight, you're without power, and in many instances, you're without water.
No doubt.
That's the way it's here in Turtle Beach, South Carolina. I'm here alone. My bad.
All right, Mike, thanks so much. I want to get some city-specific timing so we know what is still yet to come in a place like Turtle Beach, because Jackie, that's one of the areas where we're going to continue to move forward into the weekend.
Yeah, absolutely, even into Monday, and then we'll be dealing with river flooding well beyond that. So let's talk about some of the specific impacts. We're going to start out with Wilmington, and we're going to still be experiencing some of the strong wind gusts tonight, Thursday, tomorrow, even into Saturday night. But those stronger gusts that could reach hurricane force are now beginning to peter out. And so, but we can still see damage regardless of that. Rainfall amount. This is on top of what we already have, and I know it's just incredible to think of that. But we're talking another 12 to 18 inches. So that's another foot or foot and a half of rain. And a storm surge, of course, up to 5 feet. Now, what we need to know is the winds are beginning to change direction. Our winds are coming in at the southwest, so we'll walk through that change to that onshore flow that Mike Betts was talking about. And we're looking at wind gusts continuing in this area now and Saturday night. So we're talking at least 24 hours plus, where we're going to have winds strong enough to continue to cause damage. And keep in mind, the ground is so saturated here, the winds don't have to be as strong as it normally would to things like dump trees and cause all kinds of issues. Rainfall to come here as well between 12 and 18 inches, and storm surge will just begin now for tonight and into tomorrow up to 4 feet. And update for you on Morehead City, where you've received nearly 2 feet of rainfall already. Hard to believe you could be seeing another half of a foot perhaps on top of the rain cap. So flash flood emergency remains in effect there. We have a new tornado warning now. Let's give it a call for that.
Yeah, Jackie, a couple of tornado warnings actually now in North Carolina. One of those
in
Moore County that's going until 9 to 12. Let's take a look at the velocity data. In this case, we're seeing a pretty strong area of circulation there right along Route 258. So it's sitting right about in there, just southwest of Woodington, moving to the northwest very quickly. Motion here is now on to the northwest 40 miles per hour. So I'm going to track this out, taking this forward, and that's generally going to be headed towards Seven Springs, coming up to Bland's Crossroads, 915, Boss Hill, 919, Liddell, 925, and Seven Springs at 931. So you want to get to your safe place immediately in those areas. And another tornado warning on the southeast, that's Craven Jones in Onslow Counties. That's going until 9:45. Again, let's take a look at the velocity data. Not seeing anything that stands out quite as well in this case. Just sort of a shear line here near Maysville. We go back one scan right here. Maybe a little more of a circulation showing up there just southwest of Trenton. So let's go ahead and take that forward. Getting up towards Route 41 there, a possible tornado. And, but, you know, these things are often very transient. They often don't last very long at all. That would be coming towards Cummins Fork, Pleasant Hill, Johnstown, and also into Woodington. So usually they're short fuse warnings. Yeah, the warnings come out. You see a circulation there for a couple of scans, and then it's over before it started. But they certainly can be damaging tornadoes. tornadoes. We've seen that many, many times. And tornado watch, in effect, is going until 11 p.m. tonight for the eastern part of North Carolina. Still got a lot of wind to talk about, too. There's local tropical storm warnings that are now in effect in eastern North Carolina and also South Carolina as well. Winds still gusting now at 49 miles per hour in Fayetteville, also 47 miles per hour in Florence, closer to the center of circulation. When you think about what's going on with the rain here, the ground is absolutely full of water. It's actually not water covered, it's at least full of water, and that's going to allow the trees to come over a lot more easily. We've already got a crazy number of power outages. I think Brandon told me a last to check it here, 800,000. But 900,000 now without power is what we're hearing. So just a spectacular number of people without power. Tropical storm force winds continuing and going on for a very long time. There is the timing. And you see this going through Saturday evening and even into Sunday morning there in Wrightsville and in Myrtle Beach. So that is going to keep the pressure on and bring down even more trees and even more power lines across this region. A very long duration storm. Jackie, over to you.
All right, we'll stay with the Weather Channel for continuing coverage as Tropical Storm Florence continues to pound the Carolina coast. We have a team of meteorologists spread out up and down the east coast covering every angle of this storm. It's hurricane coverage that you can trust. Stay with us.
That helps prevent bleeding gums. If you spit blood when you brush or floss, you may have gum problems and could be on the journey to much worse. Help stop the journey of gum disease. Try Parodontax toothpaste. It's clinically proven to remove plaque, the main cause of bleeding gums. For healthy gums and strong teeth, leave bleeding gums behind with Parodontax toothpaste.
Made from a green ingredient. There's no harsh chemical residue and kills 99.9% of germs.
are seeing a pretty tight circulation now showing up near Maysville. You want to get to your safe place right now near Maysville. And again, that is moving off to the northwest. So that's going to be moving up towards Comfort at about 9:43. There too, you want to get to your safe places. This is going to be moving very quickly. And then to the northwest of that, another tornado warning for Duplin and Lenore counties going until 9:30. And looking at the velocity data here, there too, we're seeing a fairly strong circulation. That is just northeast of Albertson and near Woodington as well. Also moving northwest about 40 miles per hour. So that's coming to Liddell in just the next few minutes here, and we'll be moving towards Seven Springs at about 9:27 or so. And a tornado watch in effect for eastern North Carolina, and then going until 11 o'clock eastern time. We'll move again up to Alex Wilson. She's been reporting on the storm in Wilmington, North Carolina. And Alex, if you could you tell us a little bit about your day? I know it started with an awful wind as that eye wall came in early this morning.
It got pretty wild. You know, we were live from 1 to 3 a.m. So basically when the eye wall was about 20 miles offshore from Wilmington. With that said, it was only moving about 5 miles an hour. It didn't end up making landfall till close to 7 a.m. So, or until after 7 a.m., I should say. So it was about 4 hours after our live shot ended. But when we were live early in the morning, we were seeing winds gusting around 60 miles an hour. I tried to lay down, but obviously when you're staying somewhere, you're dealing with 80, 90, 100 mile an hour wind gusts. It actually feels as if an NFL team is doing high knees down the hallway. The whole building was thumping thanks to the wind. So I got to see, you know, the strongest winds move onshore. Again, this was right around, I would say, anywhere from 6 to 8 a.m. That's when we saw the power flashes. Everybody was losing power across the city, including us here at our hotel. And throughout much of the day, 50, 60 plus mile per hour wind gusts have been the norm. One thing I will say, Carl, I think within the last hour and a half, I've really noticed a serious dip in wind speed. So I think at this point, gusting 30, 35 miles an hour at this point. What has not let up, though, throughout the day has been the rain. Now, we did notice that the water from the Cape Fear River was being pushed onshore. So during the mid-afternoon, this was over the boardwalk where we've done our live shots on Wednesday. It was out into these parking lots. It still is in some of the parking lots, but it was out on the water street in front of the hotel. So the hotel itself was actually becoming an island. That's receding as we get to low tide just after 6 o'clock in the afternoon. But we think because of that persistent onshore push, we're going to be dealing with more of that. So once again, that inundation from the river and the water is going to continue to fall from the sky. So something that we've been especially concerned about in a place like Wilmington is the fresh water as well as the salt water flooding being an issue, or the flooding from the river combining with that rainfall, because that water just has nowhere to go.
That record surge today, Alex, and the rain continuing to come down. It looks like at least another 36 hours before it leaves your state. Well, Tropical Storm Florence slammed into the North Carolina coast, and it left its mark on communities across parts of the state. New Bern, this is just east of Moorhead City, seeing some of the worst flooding from the storm. The community sits along the Newt River, which quickly burst from its banks, bringing storm surges up to 12 feet into the town. And those who did not evacuate New Bern were quickly overtaken by the rising waters, with water rescue teams and other first responders rescuing hundreds of people, taking them to higher ground as storms unleashed heavy rain. Rescue workers and teams are still ongoing and continuing to search for people in that area. Well, we are continuing to track the tropical storm Florence right now. We want to go back to Carl Parker, and it's going to be a slow trek across South Carolina the next 36 hours or so.
Yeah, it's just crazy how long this whole thing is going to last. You know, gradually over the weekend, we'll lift up into the upstate of South Carolina. In the meantime, we've still got an onshore flow and an ongoing surge threat. There's a look at the latest storm surge forecast from the National Hurricane Center. They are lowering these values from the Outer Banks and down across Cape Lookout and Cape Fear to 3 to 5 feet. Notice it's still at 8 to 12 feet on the western end of the Pamlico Sound. And that includes the Neuse River and also the Pamlico River. So we're still looking for very, very high surge there. And of course, there's been a flash flood warning and emergency in that area as well. We've got water coming from both sides, coming from the Pamlico Sound and also a runoff from the tremendously heavy rain. 2 to 4 feet is the surge forecast, and that's from the Cape Fear area on down into Myrtle Beach. And high tide cycles coming up here at midnight tonight, as well as into the middle of the day tomorrow. Our live coverage of Tropical Storm Florence continues on the other side of the break. It's going to be a marathon of incredibly heavy rain and more wind aboard the
There's a bunch of places where screening would be easy. Like here. Well, here. Nope. But here's a place you can screen for colon cancer anytime with Cologuard. Any special friend. There really is no place like home.
Cologuard is not right for everyone, so ask your doctor if it's right for you.
They can be a bit uncomfortable.
Yeah, I know. I like that kind of patient.
Say no more to occasion of constipation with clinically proven effective Seneca. Satisfaction irritation of
the aches and pains from poor circulation or tired, aching legs stopping you from enjoying life. You don't have to suffer any longer. Relieve your aches and pains with Revited Medic Circulation Booster, a new drug-free halt treatment covered by the FDA that significantly improves circulation in your legs and feet. Just one relaxing session a day, and you'll be back in control. Medical conditions, age, or inactivity can cause poor circulation. The result, aches and pains that ruin your everyday life. Only Revited Medic's patented wide pulse waveforms stimulate the nerve endings in your feet to get your lower leg muscles pumping and actively improve your circulation. Relieve your aches and pains and strengthen your leg muscles.
I've tried everything to get rid of my pain, and nothing has worked like this. I'm even better. It's not a dream.
My granddaughter asked me to dance with her. Well, I can't turn down my granddaughter, right? So I danced two long dances with her, and I've never been able to do that without the garden.
A big difference. Quality of life. It's nice to have that feeling back and have the control done.
Revited Medic, easy to use. Just place your feet on the footpad and increase the intensity using the remote control. In minutes, you'll be enjoying relief as Revited's clinically proven that pulse will take your aches and pains away. Discover why 4 out of 4 people who try Revited keep it. Because it works. Try risk-free with our 60-day money-back guarantee. If Revited Medic doesn't relieve your aches and pains, return it and we'll refund the purchase price, the shipping, and even pay the return shipping. That's how confident we are in the power of Revited. Call 1-800-956-0509 or go to TryRevited.com right now. That's 1-800-956-0509.
You don't have to take what you take. You just have to take what you need. And try Revited.
The short on crispy pancakes are being fresh and it's okay to travel straight to your table. DiGiorno delivers a crispy caramelized crust straight from your oven. It's not delivered. It's DiGiorno.
Look at you, baby. 4 inches or more of rain from this system.
We could be doubling our rainfall record here as our tropical system is concerned in the state of North Carolina.
Carolina coast with damaging winds and heavy rain. Florence made landfall this morning near Wilmington, North Carolina.